Good morning, students. Welcome to my class. I hope all of you are keeping fine. So we are going to start lesson 5 in class 3B English Literature. We are going to start our half yearly syllabus. Okay. So we are going to study today lesson 5. The name of this poem is Gorilla. This is by Martin Honeysett. Okay. So let us start. You see here, getting started. Have you ever had an unwelcome guest in your house? What was the experience like? Before explaining you this poem, we are going to deal with some questions that are given here. Okay. So have you ever had an unwelcome guest in your house? The meaning is the person whom you don't like, that is the unwelcome guest. Okay, so do you like that kind of person in your house whom you don't like? Okay, what was the experience like? What was your experience? You were happy, you were sad, you were excited. Okay, so what was your experience when you don't like someone? Okay, so if that person comes to your house, how do you feel? When we have a meal with people, what do we need to remember? Okay, when we are having meal with people, we are having our suppose we are eating with someone, what are the things we should keep in mind? What are the things we need to remember at that time, isn't it? Do you know someone who eats up more than his share of a tasty dish? Do you know someone, some person, do you know who eats up more than his share? Suppose you are giving him something to eat, okay, and he eats more than his share. What is share you have given? Okay, or when the person is coming to your house, you are supposed to give that person something, but he eats more than his share. Okay, so do you know that kind of person? So here are some questions. Okay, these are in the beginning of the poem, these questions are asked so that in the lesson also we are going to deal with something like this. Okay, so let us start the poem. First, I'm going to give a reading of this poem. You have to practice reading. A giant gorilla came to tea. Whoever asked him? It wasn't me. He came in through the kitchen wall. It took 6 chairs to seat him all. He drank his tea straight from the pot, and sandwiches he ate the lot. He poked the jellies to make them wobble, then swallowed them up with just one gobble. All that remained on the plate was the cake. There was nothing else for him to take. When he had eaten that, I showed him the door and hope he'd go now. There was no more. Instead, he ate the door as well, except for the knocker and the bell. After that, he at last decided to go. Who invited him? I would like to know. Okay, students, now I'm going to explain you paragraph by paragraph. Okay, so you see the first para, this poem, it has 4 paras. Okay, a giant gorilla came to tea. Giant, a huge creature. What is the meaning of a giant? A giant means a huge creature. Okay, so you can see here gorilla. How big is the gorilla here? A giant gorilla came to tea. A big huge creature like a gorilla, he came to tea. Whoever asked him? It wasn't me. Maybe someone called him. Okay, but it wasn't the child. The child did not call him. Okay, he came in through the kitchen wall. How he came inside? He came through the kitchen wall. He cannot come through the door. It's such a big creature. So he came through the kitchen wall. You can understand. It took 6 chairs to sit him all. Now you can see how many chairs it took him to sit. It took him 6 chairs to sit. All right, you can now understand that a big creature, who is the big creature here? The big creature is the gorilla here. He came to tea. The child did not know who called him. Okay, he came through the kitchen wall. Cannot come through the door because the door is too short for him and is a big creature. And how many chairs he needed to sit? He needed 6 chairs to sit. Okay, next paragraph. He drank his tea straight from the pot. How do we drink tea? We drink tea from the cup, isn't it? Tea is served in the cup and we take the cup and we sip it. Alright, now you see here, but how he drank the tea? How the gorilla drank the tea? He drank the tea, his tea, straight from the pot. Okay, directly from the pot, he started drinking. And sandwiches, he ate the lot. He ate lots of sandwiches. Okay, now you see here. He poked the jellies to make them wobble. What he did, he poked. You know what is the meaning of poking? To pin something. That is the meaning of poking. To push with one's fingers or a sharp object. If you suppose there is a balloon and you poke it, it will blast. Isn't it? It will make a sound and it will blast. Okay. So that is poking. Okay. And what is the meaning of wobble? To move unsteadily. Now he poked the jellies to make them wobble. So he was poking all the jellies. So the jellies were moving here and there. Unsteadily they were moving. Okay. Then swallowed them up with just one gobble. And what he did? When the all the jellies were spread here and there. Okay. He swallowed them with just one gobble. He swallowed them. Everything he swallowed together. All the jellies he swallowed together with a big bite. He swallowed them up. Okay. All that remained on the plate was the cake. What was remaining on the plate now? Only the cake was left. Because he ate everything. There was nothing else for him to take. Because there was nothing else. You can see in the picture. This is page 39. You can see there was nothing else that was remaining. When he had eaten that, I showed him the door. So when he had eaten that, when he ate the cake also, the child showed him the door and hoped he would go now. There was no more. And what did the child hope? That now there is nothing to eat in the house. He ate everything. So he showed him the door and hoped that he would go now. Okay. Instead, he ate the door as well. And what happened when he showed him the door? The child showed him the door when there was nothing to eat. Instead, he ate the door as well. The gorilla ate the door also. Except for the knocker and the bell. What was left? Only the knocker. You see, the knocker through which you knock and the bell was left. These two things he cannot eat because these things are made of metal. Okay. After that, he at last decided to go. And at last, what did he decide when there was nothing left? He ate the door also. He decided to go. Who invited him? I would like to know. Now the child is thinking this, that who invited him? He wanted to know. He had that curiosity that who invited this great creature? Who invited the gorilla in the house? Okay, so this is the poem. Okay, this is just for fun, my dear. This poem is just for fun because from here we don't get any exact meaning through this poem. What we are reading, that he is an unwanted guest in the house and he came and he ate all the things. We are not getting a specific any idea. We are not getting through this poem. This poem is just for fun. Okay. You have to read this poem and you have to go through all the word meanings here. All the word meanings are given here. Poked, to to push with one's fingers or a sharp object. What is the meaning of gobble? Meaning is a big bite. Wobble, to move unsteadily. Knocker, a metal or wooden object attached to a door for rapping. So that you call through that knocker, you knock the door. Okay, so this is the poem. You have to go through the poem very nicely. Alright, once again I am reading the poem. You have to practice in this way. Alright, okay. The name of the poem is Gorilla by Martin Honeysett. A giant gorilla came to tea. Whoever asked him, it wasn't me. He came in through the kitchen wall. It took 6 chairs to sit them on. It took 6 chairs to sit him on. He drank his tea straight from the pot, and sandwiches he ate the lot. He poked the jellies to make them wobble, then swallowed them up with just one gobble. All that remained on the plate was the cake. There was nothing else for him to take. When he had eaten that, I showed him the door and hoped he would go now. There was no more. Instead, he ate the door as well, except for the knocker and the bell. After that, he at last decided to go. Who invited him? I would like to know. Okay, this is a fun-loving poem, you can say. The children would love to read this poem. You would really love to read this poem. Okay, please go through the poem. Read the poem. The most important thing is reading. You have to practice reading a lot and go through the word meanings. Okay, thank you.